Hi, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. This is Amy from With Love by Amy, and today we are making a Valentine's Day with Lawn Fawn products. All right, so to get started, here's the three stamp sets that I used. Yeah, I know, not Valentine's, right? I don't have very much Lawn Fawn in my stash, so I certainly don't have a Valentine's specifically stamp set yet. But I'm going to be very creative with these three stamp sets that don't seem like they really lend themselves to Valentine's Day. First, I'm going to pick out my papers from my scraps collection, and then I'm going to die cut. I'm die cutting the bear out of the tan paper, and then I'm going to draw fur on him with a darker pen. And I didn't get very much of the coloring of the fur on camera. I thought I recorded, and then I realized it was not recording. Oopsie. You know, when I was making this card, I felt like it was taking me only like 5 minutes. I was like, sweet, it's done. I was so speedy. Then I put all the footage together, and it was like close to 20 minutes. I was like, what the heck? I feel like that was only 5 minutes. That's not what I remember. But I guess that's what happens when you're crafting. It feels so quick, and then it's really not. But I'm going to stamp the outline of the germ-free bear on him after I am done coloring him, so that he has a little more bear-like definition than the fur that I put on him. But I do think this is a brilliant idea, and I like it. So here we go, gonna stamp the bear. And you'll be able to see what he looks like in just a second. This bear is so fun. I like that he can hold things like a heart. Alrighty. Finally stamping him. Let's see what he looks like. Ta-da! The bear looks amazing. I love it. And then next we're going to... Yep, he looks super cool. So next we're going to stamp the cookie cutter heart thing. I'm guessing that's what that's supposed to be from that Sprinkled with Joy stamp set. I die cut it first, and then I'm going to line the stamp up with the die cut piece, and I'm going to stamp it on there in black ink. That cardstock's a little bit textured, so I was a little bit concerned about how it was going to stamp, but it actually did quite well on my first try. I was impressed. We are using VersaFine Onyx Black ink for this, my favorite ink to stamp things in black with. Alrighty, and it looks amazing. So the idea is that the bear is going to hold the heart, and the bear is going to go on the center of the pink panel that I have cut down to relatively small with the stitched rectangle dies. I think it's inside out stitched rectangles, I think is what I have. I think I honestly have only like one set other than these three sets that I used. Maybe two. Oh yeah, two sets. I have Hey There that my mom sent me for my birthday last year. And I also have Costume Party, which I bought for Halloween last year. So moving on, here we are trying to arrange the sentiments. I have two sentiments there from the germ-free bear, and the other sentiment is from Sprinkled with Joy. The sweet word is from Sprinkled with Joy, and the other two sentiments are from the germ-free bear. I don't usually, if you see my cards on Instagram and stuff, I usually don't make cards that are like this much white space, I guess. They're usually more busy than this, but I did this one and I really liked how it turned out. Right now I'm conditioning the stamps. I usually use an eraser to condition the new stamps that I haven't used yet, but I was trying to be in a hurry, so I used my hand. It didn't work as well as it usually does, but whatever. It does end up stamping quite well. I did make sure that I took the bear out of there that I hadn't glued down yet, so that if there was a mishap with the stamping, I wouldn't mess up my bear, because he took me a little while to color. And I think it looks perfect. So now we're going to glue the bear together and glue him into the center and glue the heart on the bear's belly. And then the bear is going to go in between the sentiments. And I did use, on the back of that pink panel, I did use double-sided adhesive instead of liquid glue, just because I wasn't sure if it would make this, the pink cardstock isn't super thick, so I was afraid if I put liquid adhesive on the back of it, it might make it warp, so I wanted it to stay as flat and pristine as possible. So, and now I'm decorating the envelope. I do make sure when I decorate envelopes like this on the flap that I put a piece of paper in between the flap and the body of the envelope, so if any ink bleeds through, it will not ruin the rest of my envelope. I feel like that is a very important component, because you don't want to ruin your envelope when you're working so hard to make it party. And it is helpful. You'll see here at the end that the markers that I use do actually bleed through the through this envelope. I always, when I do envelopes like this with one small stamp that I think I want to put on the flap several times, I will center the one stamp in the Misti, and then I will move the envelope, just slide it along the Misti as I stamp one direction and then the other, so I can get as many stamps on there as possible based on the size of the stamp and the distance that I put between them. I'm using some Olo markers and a Sharpie, because I only have two different reds with my Olos. Excuse me, sorry. It's early in the morning and my throat is really dry, even though I drank some water before I started this voiceover. But, yeah. So I'm cleaning up my stamps, and here is my finished card. I think the bear looks adorable, and so does the envelope. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you come back soon and check out my next projects. Have a great day. See you soon.